Hi everyone, in this video we will discuss the homogeneity assumption test. It is also called homogeneity test. This assumption is about the variance equality. That means the variables in two or more groups are not significantly different. This is a required assumption for tests like ANOVA or MANOVA. So how to test this assumption? We can examine the box plot to see how the variances of variables are different across groups. We also can use the Levine's test. Let's use both methods and see how they work. We go to Analyze, select Descriptive Statistics, and select Explore. We add ID variable to label case by. We'll test this assumption with variables x6 to x18, so we move them to the dependent list. For factor list, since we are comparing variance of these variables across groups, we need to identify a categorical variable. In this data set, we have some categorical variables such as customer type, industry type, firm size, region, and distribution system. For example, we select region as the factor. It has two groups, USA and outside of USA. We need to examine the variance between these two groups. In this case, we do not need to see descriptives again, so we will skip this option. As for plots, we do not need to see the histogram, so we do not check this box. In the plots window, we see the options for Levine's test. We will check untransform to run the test with the data that we have. Click continue and click OK. In the output, we see test of homogeneity of variance. This is actually the Levine's test. If the test is significant, then we do not meet the homogeneity assumption. In other words, variance is significantly different between these two groups. So we expect non-significant test. We can see that X6 does not meet this assumption, while X7 does meet the assumption. If we examine all variables, we'll see that only X6 and X17 do not meet the homogeneity assumption. The remaining variables do meet this assumption. Let's look at the box plot of X6. It shows the box plots for two groups. We can see that the variance in group 1, USA and North America, is much smaller than the variance in group 2, outside North America. This shows the significant difference of variance between these two groups. If we look at the box plots of X7, we can see that the variance is almost the same between these two groups. Again, we only compare the variance or the size of the box. Let's look at X17. We can see the differences of variance between groups. So X6 and X17 have issues with homogeneity. So what do we do with them? Head all suggests that we should run the test again, but with different factors. For example, we will run this test again with another factor, customer type. We use the same process again. Let's examine the results. So X6 still has issues. X17 still has issues. Then we run it again with another factor, X5, distribution system. In this case, we see that X6 and X17 do not have the same issues anymore. The test for both variables is non-significant. Here all suggests that if the issues does not occur with all factors, we still consider the data acceptable for this assumption. However, please note that if you run ANOVA or MANOVA, you will have a specific categorical variable with specific groups. In this case, you need to meet the assumption for this specific categorical variable. To correct the issues, we can try the transformation. Since we already transformed the variables, we will use the transform data for this test and see if it will improve the situation. So I run with the transform data file and follow the same process. If we examine the results, we can see that X6 has improved a little bit, but X17 has improved a lot and the issue has been corrected. There is no homogeneity issues with X17. Thus, the transform data actually corrected the issues. Please note that Levine's test is also sensitive to the sample size. So if we have a large sample size, the test tends to get significant. Accordingly, if we have a very large data set and the Levine's test turns out significant, we'll need to examine the box plot to see whether the situation is acceptable. That is how to test the homogeneity assumption using SPSS. Thank you, and bye now.